There's about a gazillion ways for you to have a meme setup for your live stream. Basically setting up a way for your chat to trigger some video memes to appear on screen. Today, I would like to show you my specific meme setup that I use when I'm live streaming. This will be compatible with Twitch and YouTube and maybe a couple other platforms. We will use OBS Studio as the broadcasting software and Streamerbot to control OBS. All right, step one, believe it or not, it's looking on YouTube for green screen memes. And very quickly, you will see that there's whole playlists dedicated to that. Let's open up this one, for example. There's really a bunch. And all you have to do is pick the ones you like and download them. But how do I download YouTube videos? That's a very Googleable question. Most likely it's gonna be a website that asks you to put the YouTube link and then click download. All right, now let's say that you have a folder with a bunch of green screen videos. What do you do with them? So what you want to do is create a separate scene. And this is my actual green screen scene. I'm gonna click on it. And you'll see that I have all the memes I downloaded from YouTube. So what happens is that you import them as media sources. So you click on the plus to add a new source, you find media source, name the source, and click browse to go find that video. Once you have it, for example, you can just make sure you place it where you want it to be. And do the same thing for all of them. So after a little bit, you should have all sorts of memes all over the place. Now, before we get to removing the green screen so we can have a transparent background, we're first going to make sure that we can hear it when it plays. Because by default, you're actually not gonna be able to hear it, even though the stream will be able to hear it. So if I go here, for example, with the Minecraft one, you can see that in my mixer, it actually appears. So what I'm gonna do is click on the three little dots. I'm gonna select Advanced Audio Properties. And under all the memes that appear here, you're gonna see the play button icon next to them. You wanna set your monitor to monitor only mute output, which means it'll play out loud in your headset, but not as a source, which is what we want. We wanna be able to hear it. And since it plays on your headset and your desktop audio, which is right there, is actually catching everything that is being played on your headset, then it will catch it too. This is the same setup as you can see that I have for my alerts. My alerts play, they play in my headset, I can hear them, they're being caught by desktop audio so my stream can hear them, and then the mute output makes sure that it doesn't play twice. All right, and you'll see all the memes that are active are set to that. You can close this. And now, since I know that all of them are green screen memes, what I can do is right click on the scene itself, go to filters, click on the plus here to add a new filter, and find something called chroma key. This is basically the green screen effect. Honestly, since it's just memes, I usually keep it by default because I don't need that green screen effect to be perfect. Make sure you have it on, and now you can go back and test your memes. And as you can see, they work. Okay, we're almost done with the OBS part. What you want to do is make sure that you turn them off, all of them off. This is basically your reset. And then you pick the scenes where you want those to appear. If you're going to use them as channel points or alerts, you kind of want them on every scene. So go on your scenes and make sure you add them. For example, here, this is my just chatting scene. I would go ahead and go to click on the plus here to add a new source, pick scene, and then I would choose green screen right there. But since this is already my setup, I already have it somewhere right there. There it is. If you want it on your starting soon screen, do the same thing. Your gameplay scene, do the same thing. Your be right back screen, anywhere you know people are gonna trigger them, put them in there. All right, I believe it's time for Streamerbot. I'm not gonna show you how to download Streamerbot and install Streamerbot and get Streamerbot going, but I do have a video on the basics on how to get Streamerbot going. So make sure you watch that if this is your first time using Streamerbot. If it's not, you're gonna be able to follow along just fine. We're assuming that you got your Streamerbot connected to OBS, also connected to whatever channel you're going to use, Twitch or YouTube. We're going to go under the actions tab and we're going to create a new action. We will also create a new group. So let's say we had that Shrek meme, right? What I would do is name this Shrek meme. And under group, I would call this, I already have a group with all my actions. You can see them right there, my 9 actions. Now that's pretty much it. Click okay. Under sub actions, I will make it do whatever I want. So in this case, what do we want? We want the Shrek meme to turn on, to wait for its duration, and then to turn off. Now, first things first, how do we turn something on? We're gonna right click, go to OBS, scroll to sources, and then we will find set source visibility state. Boom. Here we will select the specific scene. It is our green screen scene. We will select the source. We set Shrek and state visible by default. Click OK. All right. Next one is make it wait for the video to play before turning it off. Now, how do we figure out how long the video is? That's a great question. Let's figure it out by just playing it and looking. So green screen, Shrek meme is right there. I'm going to click. Technically, I don't even have to do because OBS is actually already telling me right there that it is 8 seconds. So with that information, we can go back under sub actions, right click, go to core, go to delay. This is the waiting action basically. And you can set 8,000 milliseconds. And finally, what's left to do, turning it off after the 8,000 milliseconds. Since we're lazy here, I'm gonna right click on the first one and I'm gonna click duplicate sub action. We'll see that it made another one for us. I will double click on that and just set the state to hidden. That's it. Three actions. Turn it on, wait 8 seconds, turn it off. All right, now when it comes to triggers, this is where you pick how it's going to be triggered. Is it gonna be a chat command? Is it gonna be channel point rewards if you're on Twitch? Is it going to be a super chat if you're on YouTube? Is it gonna be with new subs? To be fair, with YouTube, you can use them as alerts or chat commands. So let's right click under triggers and you can see all that is available to us. Under YouTube chat, we have first words, message, a super chat, and a super sticker, new sponsor, new subscriber. You can even play a meme when a user gets banned. Memberships and all that good stuff. For Twitch, you definitely get more options. Me personally, I like channel point rewards because in chat, it comes with a little menu that people can just pick which meme they want. But we can also make it a chat command. We can also make it a regular alert for bits, subs, gifted subs, follows, watch streaks, follower mode on. So it's hard for me to make a tutorial where I show you every single trigger. So I highly encourage you watch other tutorials showing the specific trigger you want. I'm going to go with a chat command because this will be more universal. And the way you do that is by right-clicking under triggers, going to core, going to commands, and clicking on command triggered. Now, if you already created your command separately, you can find it in the list. If you haven't, you can create a new command right here. Now, don't be intimidated by this. It's very simple. You only need the name of the command. That's how it's gonna show up on your list of commands. And the command itself, exclamation mark, Shrek. Now, if you want specific stuff, you can play around with the permissions and all of that. But one thing that's important is right there, sources. You can choose which platform the chat command is supposed to come from. Look at that. Actually, I never realized that you can have commands from Twitch Whispers. That's wild. Over here, you can also set them for subscribers only, but we're not gonna mess with all that. We're just gonna click OK and OK one more time. And that's it. Now, if you wanna test it without going to your channel and typing out the command, you can right click on this and click test trigger. As you can see, it's just instant. It works. But if you need some reassurance, I don't blame you. I'm gonna go and open a chat doc. I think I have one. Or you would just go to your channel, go to the chat and try typing exclamation mark Shrek. And we will see how instant it is. Booyah. There it is. It plays for the 8 seconds. And then we can physically see it turning off afterwards. And that's it, which means that if you're streaming on your just chatting scene, right there, someone comes in, they type the command, this will appear right there, exactly where you placed it. If you need to move Shrek, for example, you can just go back on that scene and just physically place it, scale it, do whatever you want with it. And that's all there is to it. That is my setup for my green screen videos that appear with channel points. If you want to have a better look at my actual setup, I can show it to you. So it's right there. It's 9 actions. Some of them probably aren't there anymore, but you can see the source is a Twitch channel reward and it's turn on, wait, turn off. Turn on, wait, turn off. If you wanna go faster, I believe you can duplicate actions and all you have to do is basically switch the source, but then you also have to switch the command or the channel point. So I don't know how much time you can actually save by just right-clicking and duplicating the action. So yeah, subscribe if you want more videos like this. I'm currently working on a game that chat can play by just typing a single command and they'll be able to pull different items of different rarity. I'm actually making a whole 3D animation for it. So yeah, turn on that notification bell so you don't miss that one. And I'll see you next time. Go follow me on Twitch and also go out there. Make me proud. Get a level. Out.